greatest benefit of the OCT biometry module is that we have a visual confirmation of the elements of the eye. In other words, we will see the cornea, the crystalline lens, anterior and posterior segments, and the macula with a level of detail that will allow us to select the exact measurement points so that we can be sure that our measurements are correct. It is a complement to our practice with the state-of-the-art technology, which is OCT, that allows us to confirm not only the values, but also the visual confirmation that the distances we are measuring are actually made at the exact points we need them to be measured. What do I mean by this? In the macula, we can millimetrically or nanometrically position it exactly on the pigment epithelium, neither before nor after. And you can only do this because you have OCT technology doing the biometry. So, if you seek to professionalize, to improve, to have a validation of the measurements you take in your current practice, I believe that a biometry module is the ideal candidate for your case. When we need to do a biometry reading, once we have the patient selected, we will go to the measurement screen. We will go to anterior segment where we can choose axial length and length thickness. First, we are going to choose axial length. We have three modes: auto, manual, and burst. The one I recommend using is burst mode. This will allow us to make a sequence of automatic measurements once we have the measurement position selected. Once we have everything set, the patient in position and ready to measure, it is important that we do not move the instrument and that the patient stays still. If for any reason the patient moved abruptly or withdrew from the position, we will repeat the measurement to ensure accurate results. We can also choose whether it is a phakic lens, aphakic, a PMA, silicone, or acrylic. In this case, we select 5 measurements, so it will be an automated sequence, 5 measurements simultaneously, and we have here the 4.5 mm range and ultra-fine sensitivity. Click OK. And now, in the same way we do in a conventional OCT capture, we're going to see on the video, initially on the left screen, that as we zoom in, we're going to see the circles projected on the cornea. We're going to try to bring them closer to the blue circles. Here it shows us that we are still far. Now we are going to gently move closer until the yellow circle appears. Returning to the screen on the left, we will see that we have two dots, one on each side. It's important to get them in focus. You will see now, if I move away, they disappear. If I get closer, they focus. And if I get closer than necessary, they will go out of focus again. When these dots are one on each side and in focus, we know that we are at the correct measuring distance. On the upper left, where we can see a red line, there are two white lights projected, indicating whether the refraction for the measurement is correct for the patient. We can confirm the position with the image of the pupil on the bottom. Once we are in position, we will be able to optimize either on the instrument or on the screen. Now we are going to select the image of the macula so that it aligns with the blue lines. And once we have everything in position, we are going to tell the patient to keep the eye open and to stay still. In this case, we press without moving the instrument and making sure the patient can also keep still so that the equipment can take all the measurements in burst mode. Perfect. We have the possibility of confirming, in this case, the 5 measurements, where we can make a manual adjustment if required. We have a standard deviation at the bottom, SD, of 0.03, which is indicating that the standard deviation of all measurements is adequate. In the upper image, we can see the cornea and confirm it is located correctly. It automatically detected it properly. If we have to make an adjustment, we can do it with the arrows to make a fine adjustment. In this case, we can also see the image of the macula at the bottom, where we will be able to choose the correct position to measure the axial length. Once we corroborate this, we can click on Analyze. Perfect. Once the axial length measurement is complete, we can go to the Measurement tab to select Length Thickness. In this case, we will again choose the Burst option. We can choose the type of lens, 5 measurements continuously. Click OK. First, With the instrument pushed back, we are going to tell the patient to look at the green light in the center and not to be distracted by the red lights of the scan. And at this moment, the patient can blink occasionally while we do the alignment ready for the measurement. Looking at the video on the left side, we are going to center it with the pupil and we are going to slowly come closer and press scan start. With scan start, we will already see the OCT image. We slowly come closer until we see the image of the cornea. We are going to try to line up the upper part of the cornea with the blue line that we see on the screen, and we are going to raise and lower the instrument with the joystick until we see the vertical light beam. And we press optimize. And once we finish optimizing, we will tell the patient to please keep the eye open and press the capture button. Without moving the instrument, the equipment will take all the five measurements automatically and consecutively. And now it is switching to the back of the crystalline lens to conclude the five necessary measurements to calculate the length thickness. Very good. Here we will be able to confirm all the measurements. In this case, we can make a slight adjustment. Standard deviations are correct. Let's go to analyze. Once we finish taking all the measurements for the biometry, such as length thickness, axial length, etc., also topography that can be useful for keratometries, and also white to white, that is the wide range full or 16 millimeters, we already have all the information for a complete biometry. And now we can do the complete biometry study on this screen. We can see that at the top we have the white-to-white image. At the bottom we have a topography or a radial study where we can see the cornea. And in the center we have the axial length readings, where we can see all five measurements. We can confirm the average, the standard deviation, which in this case is very good, and further down we have the visual confirmation of both the cornea and the macula, where we can see, by selecting each value, the precise points of each measurement. If we click on each one, we can make slight modifications in the position in case it is required. If we double-click here or on the cornea, we can choose and make modifications if we have a small deviation. In the case of length thickness, the presentation is very similar. We have the five measurements and we can select each one. The values of ACD, length thickness, and central cornea thickness. And we have the standard deviations, the average values, and below, the visual confirmation of each and every measurement. In this case, we also have the possibility to make slight modifications if required, to have even more precise measurements. We can also have the visual confirmation here with the anterior and posterior lens in this case. We can also select different measurements from different dates and times even. In this case, in this patient, we only made a single measurement, so only one is displayed. We can also visualize it in both eyes simultaneously. In the upper left, we can choose the date and time of each study for each eye and axial length and lens thickness. As we can see, we have all the information from both eyes to generate a report quickly, and we always have the option to print on a printer via USB network, or also save the file as a PDF to any network location or USB storage media. Another important thing when doing the biometry analysis is that we can use the built-in calculator that is incorporated in the OCT. In this case, we have the measurements of the left eye of either axial length, K1, K2, and the axis. And we will be able to choose along multiple lens manufacturers and their models, as well as the formulas SRK2, SRKT, Hoffer Q, Holiday, Huygens, and Kamelin Kalossi, as well as Shamas. This way, we will be able to correctly choose the lens that we want to use with the biometry and with all the studies that we just did. It is also important to clarify that in case the lens is not in the updated database of the equipment, we can add it manually. This is also an important alternative if you are considering using alternative lenses to those that normally come with the equipment. In the case of biometry, something that I think is fantastic is, in the case of premium lenses, or more complicated cases with denser cataracts, for example, where you have certain complications with traditional technology, the OCT is an alternative that allows you to add a contrast measurement. It also adds the possibility of having a visual confirmation of these measurement points in detail, and it's something that complements the practice and really allows you to have more confidence before doing a cataract surgery. It is a module that complements and enhances the ophthalmic practice in a very appealing way. I think these are modules that add value. They add even more possibilities of measurement confirmation. These are features of a new technology, which are unified in an OCT package. It is very important to keep this in mind, even for people who have already acquired the OCT, to know that this possibility exists. It's also very important to mention that all of this is made possible by Huvitz. Huvitz has consistently demonstrated its commitment to quality equipment. So, not only do we have a proven technology, but we also have the backing of Huvitz's trajectory and commitment to innovation that allows us to go one step further and provide an ever better experience, both for ophthalmologists and the workflow within the clinic, as well as for the patient.